So good to have you with us. Ernie Johnson here. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports, joined as always by Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight we'll see the Miami Heat playing against the Nuggets in Denver. And when you take a look at the Nuggets, this is a big game coming up for them. They've dropped their first two games, and the last thing they want to do is open the season 0-3. That is not the way to tip things off. Hey, Shaq, part of any new season is getting used to maybe new teammates or new coaches, that kind of thing. How does that all come together?
Well, Ernie, the first road trip can really solidify that chemistry. You eat together, you hang out together, you practice together, you get to know each other. It's something that happens both on and off the court.
Would you put anybody through the rookie treatment back when you were a player?
That's G14 classified information, Ernie. Snitches get snitches.
Well, those were words to live by. Kevin, take it away.
And welcome, everyone, to another presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. Along with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. For the Miami Heat, they're coming off a loss to the Bucks.
I thought overall, Kevin, it was mostly the defensive effort that hurt them. Just no energy, no purpose.
Steve, I thought they were late on their rotations. They didn't really communicate well, and as a result, they paid for it.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the floor for Miami, Speedy out there with the bodyguard. Then there's the mayor. Then there's Dimes. And it's Howard in its small forward. Clock is at 3. The high post shot. Count that one. And so here is Miami.
A lot of questions to ask about Denver after last season. Really, it's hard to get a read on how good this team is and can be.
And that one's good. House. Here's the waiter. Out to the right wing. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Here's Carroll. Clock at 6. Here's the waiter on the money from 12 feet away. The waiter's got his first bucket of the night.
You know, Kevin, he's not always looking to put up big numbers, but he's doing a nice job here.
House, the pass to Speedy. He kicks it to House. Pass to Dimes. Carries it down low.
Well, they just gave him 2 points. Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
On defense, Miami. This, the first chance to take a look at the Nuggets this season.
Well, going back to last year for a second, this was one of the few matchups that they didn't get the better end of things. They split the season series. He's far too tentative in the paint, and even more so when the defender is up tight on him like that time.
Denver grabs the miss. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
Yeah, I thought their defense in that game was about as shaky as it could be. At home, you know, that kind of defense isn't going to cut it. Never mind if you're on the road.
They really look tired to me, and I don't know if they had travel issues or if they were out too late, but something was amiss because they had no energy.
Steve, you mentioned the stalemate they played to a year ago. Do you see that happening again this year, Clark?
Kevin, I'm not sure. It's really too early to tell. It wouldn't surprise me, I'd say that much, after what happened last year. I like the way they're working the ball inside, because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots, and typically good things happen.
Here's the waiter. There's the feed to Reed. He dishes it to Carroll. From 13, here's Z, and good work on the boards, and they pick up the second chance points.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Passes it to Speedy. Drills the elbow jumper. Speedy's got his first points of the game.
How about this? They're shooting 80% so far. I know it's early, but offensively, they look great.
Reed kicks to Carroll. Back to Reed. The floater. Rebound by the Heat. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Eric Spoelstra. And what'd you find out, Doris?
Well, Kevin, he basically wants to put a ton of pressure on the ball when the other guys are bringing it up the court. He anticipates plenty of opportunities to create steals and turn them into easy points on the opposite end, freeing up their offense a bit, Kev.
Okay, thank you, Doris. And the defensive approach, guys, how do you think that'll play out here?
I don't know, Kevin. I'm not sure they should be more focused on their opponent than they are on themselves.
That is sort of the way it sounds, Steve, but still, I don't think a defense-first mindset is ever a bad thing.
Howard, the pass to Moss. There's a screen. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in.
The screen play worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screen play you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
And the pass to Carroll. Here's the waiter. To the paint, Norris. Count that one.
Norris!
For Miami, they've gone 5 of 7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway. Here is House. Back to Howard. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on him.
The Nuggets trail. Feeds to Carroll. Inside. Can't throw it down with one hand.
You rarely see him missing dunks, but the defender was right in his face on that one, and it threw him off just enough.
See the way he times his passes so well? It was a great assist.
Big group substitution here for Denver. Martin's checked in for Shorty. Jones comes in for Reed. The Cobra is checked in for Smooth. And it's Garbage Man in for the waiter. And then for Miami, Howell's checked in for Dimes. Mr. Move comes in for the mayor. And Easy Breezy subbed in for the bodyguard. Now here's Jones. Fires from the line. No good off the back of the rim. There were a lot of great things Steve accomplished last year by the Heat, both on offense and defense. But at times, people would overlook that defense.
Well, they played tremendous defense. I mean, maybe not as consistently as they have in the past, but, you know, to be as good as they were, you have to be great defensively, and I think sometimes that goes underappreciated.
Jones with it. He's guarded by Howard. Jones drives in, and a strong finish with two hands. None of the defenders wanted anything Clark to do with him on that jam.
And I do not blame him at all, partner. He was coming in with a bunch of steam and was ready to posterize whoever decided to get in his way.
All right, I understand, fellas, but come on. You've got to challenge him a little bit at least.
Here is Garbage Man. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Pass to Magician. The tray, and he gets the bucket. It's all knotted up.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Manning the pass to Dudley. To the wing right side. It's stolen. Here's the Cobra. Passes it to Garbage Man. Outside, Jones. The pass to the Cobra. Charity stripe shot, and again it's Denver. It could go. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Nuggets ahead. They lead by 2. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. And when you consider how Denver is doing, Steve and Clark, what are your thoughts?
And you get a chance early on to see their depth. They got a nice effort from their bench players early in this game.
Yeah, Steve, I tell you what, their subs have really packed the punch for them so far.
On the court for Miami here in the second. Sanders is out there with Bridges. Then it's the Cobra. Then it's Thomas. And it's Dudley in at the point.
No, the only tough part of that basket for him was getting into such good position. The rest seemed easy.
And here are the Nuggets now. The Heat getting the bucket. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. And now, courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here are the teams that led the NBA in block shots last year. Fourth, the Nuggets.
They've got a number of guys that can deny you when you take that ball inside. That's why they're one of the best shot-blocking teams in the league, at least they were last year, because they worked well together and they made it a priority.
And the first one at the line is good.
Well, if you remember early in Eric Spoelstra's head coaching career, when he was new and the big three were assembled, there were some people questioning Spoelstra's command, maybe even within the team. Those questions are long gone now. He has become an excellent head coach.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Dimes, he's checked in for Howell. And Speedy subbed in for Easy Breezy. And Coach Spoelstra, known for his work ethic and attention to detail, he's a grinder.
No question about it, Kevin. Got his start as a video coordinator back when everything ran on VHS, so you know he had to do an awful lot of work. And he's worked his way up slowly but surely. He's grown as an assistant under some terrific mentors, and now he's really, I think, one of the best head coaches in the game, without question.
He's visited college football training facilities, NFL camps. He really tries to broaden his position.
He sure does, and you can see evidence of that in how he handles himself.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, over to you.
Well, gentlemen, the NBA is taking steps to tweak the NBA lottery. It was a move a long time coming as debate raged in recent years about teams, quote, tanking for top picks. Commissioner Adam Silver had long defended those teams looking to rebuild and go young. But guys, in this business, perception is reality, and he felt they had to make a change.
We'll see how it works out, Doris. Thanks. Here's Big Red after the Heat pick up two. Shot clock at five. Here's Hall. Here's Z. No good with the layup. The Heat have gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Kicks to Sanders. Pass to Bridges. And Thomas has it in the corner. And out of bounds as the Nuggets gain possession.
Well, let's look back to last year's Nuggets while we've got a moment here, Kevin. Second in rebounding, fourth in blocks. And they were in the top 10 in team scoring as well. This is a team that prides itself on its offensive firepower. And they get it done at that end of the court.
And this is a team that really relied most heavily on the rebounding numbers that you talked about. I mean, the top five, they're a team that likes to attack the lane at both ends of the floor, really control the glass on defense and try to pound you inside with the offensive board.
For the Nuggets, Shorty comes in for Barton. The Waiters subbed in for Garbage Man. Two minutes now played in the second quarter. Norris, the pass to Hall. Inside. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. And the Nuggets lead by two.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Yeah, they've been the aggressors, Clark, and getting the ball inside into that lane area has been huge for them.
Here's Bridges. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Just four to shoot. And that misses. That would have put him up. The Nuggets have gone 1-3 to start out the second quarter.
You know, when you're coming off a championship, actually make that two consecutive championships, it's even more okay to be more concerned about the postseason than the regular season. You kind of figure out how to manage the regular season. And the Heat clearly took that approach, or at least it seemed that.
Heat shooting has been just great so far, up at 56%. Down low, here's Dimes. Soft touch off the glass. Dimes got the game tied up here for the Heat.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. The defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Yeah, they're getting exposed right now.
Here's the Dude. Here's Z. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that, Z's got the lead up to two now for the Nuggets. Heat have gone 50% from the floor in the second quarter, 3 of 6. They set the pick. In Sanders, here we go. And it's Denver with the rebound. Shorty's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Good on the shot. Now it's a 4-point Denver lead.
Beautiful job angling his body, shielding the big man from the ball on his way to the basket.
That's really the only way to do it if you're going to take it down there amongst the tall trees.
Now here's Thomas. Pass to Bridges. Back to Thomas. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Bridges passes to Thomas. Here's Booth. That's good. That's Thomas picking up the assist.
Assisted by Thomas.
Denver shooting the ball really well in this game. 58%. Passes it to Big Red. Here's the Dude. Now the pass to the Waiter. It's intercepted. And here's Sanders. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
Give an assist there, not for the pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed him up and made the layup possible.
Down low.
In this quarter, he's really been off the mark. He just looks a little bit unsettled.
Thomas kicks to Sanders. Here's Dimes, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Dimes got 4 points now in the quarter.
You got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
1:24 left in the first half of the game. Big Red passes to Hall. Clock at 4. From deep. They get the rebound. The Heat with the lead. Dishes it to Sanders. He feeds it to Thomas. Back to Sanders. Up and in on the layup. Sanders has got his second basket of the game. The Nuggets have gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Big Red passes to Hall. Here's the Waiter. Pass to Big Red. Here's the Waiter. Gets the 3-pointer to fall. The Waiter's got 5 now. For Miami, they've gotten 7 of their 12 field goal attempts to drop here in the second quarter. Up over 50%. Lets it go from the wing. It's hauled in by the Nuggets.
He got the shot he wanted off that pick, just couldn't get it to fall.
But Steve, they'll take that play all day long, 10 times out of 10. That was good action.
Passes to Hall. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2.
You know, even from here, you could see that one pretty clearly.
Yep, pretty obvious. And a good call by the officials.
This is his first free throw of the game.
At the line for 2.
That free throw, no good. So both teams changing it up here. And he's good on the second. So a tie game here as we finish the first half. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Coach, how have you been able to get your offense clicking in this first half?
Well, finally we were able to get some stops. We were able to get a couple easy ones in the open court. A little bit more patience to try to get something at the rim.
Coach, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you.
Thank you, Doris, and we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime. Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third. Dimes with a strong contribution so far in this one.
I think like he made everything he got. I mean, anytime he had an open look, he took advantage of the opportunity there in that first half.
And Steve, they were all good looks. I mean, his shot selection has been terrific throughout the game.
We've got Reed smooth out there with the Z, and it's Norris in at the center position. That's the group in the game for the Nuggets.
For a team that had normally made a habit of beating up on teams from the East, the Nuggets were just okay against the Eastern Conference last year.
That's good.
Norris!
Shorty's got the game tied up here for the Nuggets. And the Heat shooting indicative of smooth offensive play up at 60%. They're a machine from the floor. There's the pick. Now here is Howard. Shot clock at 6. As you said, the Nuggets have done very well against Eastern teams in the last few years, but Mark, just a bit over 500 against the conference last season.
Well, a 16-14 mark, not too bad, Kevin, but when every playoff team in the West wins at least 20 games against the East, then obviously you're trailing the pack there.
And that one falls for Howard.
You know, the Denver Nuggets had a ton of injuries last year, and it's hard to say exactly where this team could have ended up if they were able to stay healthy.
Howard hits them both.
As you said, Denver last year, you know, injuries took their toll as four different players were shut down for the season.
The waiter passes to Carroll. And for those of you tuning in, we're about a minute into the second half. Howard against Reed. The dish to Carroll. Let's it fly from 18. The shot is off. The Heat go the other way with it. Injuries hit him.
Oh, get it! Oh, watch out now! Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, startling that he'd even try that right now.
Here's the waiter. He's got 5. First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter. Here's Carroll. From past the arc. That's good, and the Heat lead is cut to just 1 in the basket from the waiter. The waiter's got his 3rd basket of the night. The waiter's gone 3-for-4 from the floor tonight. Speedy, the pass to House. Here's Speedy. Here's the bodyguard. Powered wide open, and they come right back with their own 3-pointer.
Up and in on every one of their first 3 shots to start the second half.
Time called here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over.
Well, you know, both of these teams certainly in the conversation when you talk about NBA dynasties, you know, with some epic finals performances to show for it. Always a pleasure to watch these two teams face off.
Barton's checked in for Denver. Easy Breezy's checked in for Miami. And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what the Nuggets head coach was saying to his team.
Norris!
He told us, guys, when we've got the ball, let's take it right into the teeth of the defense. Attacking the basket is going to be their M.O. The other thing he stressed was the need to be disciplined on offense. He asked for good ball movement and good shot selection. Perhaps the rest of the second half will look different after those adjustments, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thanks. And stylistically, the Spurs and the Heat at different ends of the spectrum, certainly. Steve, the Spurs averse to the glitter and the glamour.
Yeah, whereas in Miami, you got the pyrotechnics, the fog machines. It's star power all the way. And I think, in a way, the NBA kind of needs both approaches. They both have their place.
Unloads from 9, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Nuggets will retain possession. A different look for Denver. Jones checked in for Shorty. Silk comes in for Smooth. And it's the Cobra in for the waiter. And Miami with a change here, too. The Monsters checked in for the bodyguard. Here's Norris. Misses off the right iron.
That's not his shot there, guys. And whether you play D on him or not, he's usually going to miss that one.
Howard drives in. Dudley dishes to House. There's the screen. Here's Sullivan. Offensive rebound. And another shot. Misses at the rim.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
Back to Jones. Here's Barton. And that one's good.
You gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
Yeah, that was your game, Clark. Pound it inside and take the ball right to the defense.
That's what I tried to do, man. I knew my limitations.
And Miami has possession. The Nuggets getting the bucket. House. That's good. Enzo Howard with the assist.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
Now here's Jones. And the pass to the Cobra. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Shot clock at 5. Here's Reed. And it's Denver scoring again.
You know, he's got a quick trigger from that range when he senses that the defense has backed off.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Well, some of the faces changed both on the floor and on the sideline for Denver last year, but they were still able to get up and down the floor for a lot of points.
Garbage man, he's checked in for Denver. And a new group in for the Heat. Howell's checked in for Dimes. Sanders comes in for the Mayor. Mr. Moves checked in for Thunder. And the Great One subbed in for Easy Breezy. Here's the Great One. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. For Denver, Clark, they weren't quite as reliant on their fast break scoring, but it was still up there, as you said.
Yeah, they were able to mix it up a bit, but still found themselves in the top 10 in the league in fast break scoring. I think they're best when they run.
Here is Garbage Man. Teardrop out. That's good. Garbage Man's got the game tied up here for the Nuggets.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Really did a nice job recognizing the mismatch that he had and immediately cashing in with that mid-range jumper.
Here's Silk. The Heat getting the bucket. Pass to Garbage Man. He kicks it to Jones. Here is Garbage Man. Sanders covering. Here's Garbage Man. It's hauled in by the Heat.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
And Jones pulls it down.
That's kind of a shocker. The defense was there, but it wasn't right in his face. Kind of out of character for him to miss those.
Pass to Garbage Man. Outside, Jones. To the inside. Can't get it to fall. Miami's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. The pass to Sullivan. Here's Mr. Moves. The feed to Sanders. Sullivan, the pass to Mr. Moves. From the baseline. No good.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. Sullivan, the pass to Howell. Here's the monster. Pass to Manning. Shot clock at 6. Cans the 12-footer. The Great One's got 4 this quarter. 8 seconds left here in the third quarter. Here's Garbage Man. Good on the baseline, Jay. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Heat lead by 2. From the Pepsi Center in downtown Denver, we're back in a moment. Denver's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. On the floor for Miami, starting the fourth. We've got Howell. Bridges out there with the Mayor. Then there's the Great One, and it's Moss in at the shooting guard position.
Heads up, aggressive play right there. He saw the smaller man on him, took it straight to the basket.
Right wing. Here's the great one. There's a good screen. Pass to Howell. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
Garbage man, the pass to Kira. Here's Magician. Feeds to Carroll. Six to shoot. And there's the pass to Magician. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. The Heat with the lead. Pass to House. Here's Bridges. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Unstoppable offense from both teams. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one. Hang time on that rim, puts a little whipped cream on that angel food cake there.
It's a tight ball game, and those displays of strength, Clark, can get one team rolling.
Agreed.
Oh, boy. Whipped cream, cherry on top. It always comes back to dessert for Clark.
He used that pick to perfection.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
Denver calls timeout.
Well, he sees something that he doesn't like. I'm not sure what it is, but I think he's going to make some changes here.
I think you've got to make your adjustments pretty quickly like he's doing here. Otherwise, you know, things can get out of hand. So this is a good timeout.
The wait is checked in for Garbage Man. Then for the Heat, Dimes is checked in for Howell. Thunder comes in for Bridges. And Speedy subbed in for the great one. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what the Nuggets head coach was saying to his team. He told us, guys, I know we can do this, fellas. Let's maximize every possession and get after it. And just watch. Things will go our way. Kevin?
Here's Shorty. Here's Z. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Well, we've seen that more than a few times. An easy bucket in the lane.
Yeah, the interior defense simply has been lifeless.
And Howard, here we go. Again, the Heat, good for two.
And assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Really an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Here's Carroll. Here's Magician. A three-pointer, no good. The Heat leading by four. In low to Howard. Speedy the pass to House. Makes it off the glass.
An excellent display of passing out there, fellas. I mean, 8 of their last 10 points have been assisted on.
Well, they continue to find the open man and play unselfishly. This is true team basketball we're seeing.
Here's Magician. He dishes it to Kira. Here's the waiter. Pass to Magician. Lets it go with a three. And he gets it to go.
Defenders need to recognize and be alert to staying on him as we get into crunch time.
Timeout called, the Heat. Denver making a switch here. Reed's checked in. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. From 13, here's Dimes. And he finishes nicely on the layup. The Nuggets trail by 5. The waiter passes to Reed. The Nuggets moving the ball around. Got a piece of it. Passes it to the waiter. Unloads, and there's another one for the Nuggets.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
The Heat leading by 3. Out to the right wing. Here is House. Here's Booth. Over to the wing. Here's the bodyguard. Second chance shot. He lays it in. The bodyguard's got 4 this quarter.
Their prowess inside has been tremendous, guys. I mean, it's been no contest down on the low block.
And until they prove they can stop them, I mean, they ought to continue to pound it in low.
Here's the waiter. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. And he gets it to go. And it's a 7-point Miami lead. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Heat.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
Now, it seems to me that they're taking a lot of pride in their rebounding tonight, especially at the offensive end, guys. Another rebound gobbled up. They are pounding the boards.
And a big part of the lead, guys, is because of the work they've done on the glass. I mean, they have the lead because they've rebounded well.
Time called here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over. They trail by 9. 1:39 left in the fourth quarter. Carroll passes to the waiter. Over to the wing. Kicks it to Reed. From past the arc. And that one's good.
No, he's been a real positive factor for them today. Although, you know, as a team, they've had a lot of negatives mixed in there as well.
Here is House. Speedy the pass to Howard. Here's Dimes. That's good. And so Howard with the assist. That's 12 points for Dimes. Dishes it to Carroll. Puts up a three. Rebound by House.
Well, there's a reason he's open out there. The defense not really respecting his ability to make that shot.
Over to the left wing. Dimes the pass to House. Here's the bodyguard. 5 on the clock. Cashes in for a double-digit lead. And the Heat lead by 10.
And they're not finished yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
Yeah, that's how you close out a game, Steve.
Outside Carroll. Miami grabs the miss.
Boy, the defense just backing off, begging him to take that shot.
Howard kicks to House. Back to Howard. Here's the screen. To the wing on the left. Speedy the pass to Moss. His three-pointer's off the mark. To the right side. Here's the waiter. Drills it from outside.
They are killing them with that three-point shot here in the second half.
Well, the defense fully stretched out trying to stop that shot and still not able to get it done.
And so it's Miami winning this one. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
Well, it's time to say so long. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Dimes.